A black hole is a region in space where the pull of gravity is so strong that if an elephant tried to escape, it couldn't. Actually, nothing, not even light, can escape from a black hole. This is why it is invisible. Black holes have a number of weird properties. They are very mysterious objects. A black hole surface, called its event horizon, defines the boundary where the velocity needed to escape exceeds the speed of light, which is the speed limit of the cosmos. Matter and radiation fall in, but they can't get out. Two main classes of black holes have been extensively observed. Stellar mass black holes with 3 to dozens of times the sun's mass are spread throughout our Milky Way galaxy, while supermassive monsters weighing 100,000 to billions of solar masses are found in the centers of most big galaxies. Don't worry, we will never fall into a black hole. Chances are very low. Once born, black holes can grow by accreting matter that falls into them, including gas stripped from neighboring stars and even other black holes. They are hungry all the time, becoming bigger and bigger as time passes by. No matter their starting size, black holes can grow throughout their lives, slurping gas and dust from any object that creep too close. Anything that passes the event horizon, the point at which escape becomes impossible, is in theory destined for spaghettification, thanks to a sharp increase in the strength of gravity as you fall into the black hole. In fact, black holes' favorite plate is spaghetti. The Milky Way hosts its own supermassive black hole at its center, known as Sagittarius A star, that is more than 4 million times as massive as our own sun. The tiniest members of the black hole family are, so far, theoretical. These small vortices of darkness may have swirled to life soon after the universe formed with the Big Bang, some 13.7 billion years ago, and then quickly evaporated. Astronomers also suspect that a class of objects called intermediate mass black holes exist in the universe, although evidence for them is so far debatable. But how are black holes formed? Follow me on this journey through the universe to find out more about black holes. You will learn how a black hole is formed, how many types of black holes we can observe, and finally, we will give you a list of 3 of the most massive black holes in the universe. Okay, let's go, because we're getting antsy. Black holes can be formed in a number of ways. The most commonly known way a black hole forms is by stellar death. Some black holes can be formed directly from very big stars, more than 25 to hundreds of times bigger than our sun, when these stars collapse at the end of their lives. Gravitational collapse occurs when an object's internal pressure is insufficient to resist the object's own gravity. For stars, this usually occurs either because a star has too little fuel left to maintain its temperature through stellar nucleosynthesis, or because a star that would have been stable receives extra matter in a way that does not raise its core temperature. In either case, the star's temperature is no longer high enough to prevent it from collapsing under its own weight. Which type forms depends on the mass of the remnant of the original star left if the outer layers have been blown away. For example, in a type 2 supernova. After a supernova event, the core of the massive star that is left over after the explosion is still too massive to support itself against gravity. Therefore, it continues to collapse, causing all of this leftover mass to be compressed into a very small space, forming a black hole. These black holes typically have mass 3 to 10 times the mass of the Sun and are called stellar mass black holes. It is thought that there are around 100 million stellar mass black holes orbiting within our own galaxy. After their formation, stellar mass black holes can continue to grow as they accumulate more matter from their surroundings, such as other stars, gas, and other black holes. If a black hole absorbs enough material, it can even grow to be more massive than a million suns. These extremely massive black holes are called supermassive black holes and are the largest black holes. Supermassive black holes exist at the centers of most galaxies. One even exists at the center of the galaxy that we live in, the Milky Way. It's believed that in the conditions of the early universe, there were a lot of large, short-lived stars. Therefore, many stellar mass black holes may have existed, which then gradually accumulated material and merged together over time, creating more massive black holes, eventually containing enough mass to be a supermassive black hole. Black holes that have a mass in between the stellar and supermassive black holes are referred to as intermediate mass black holes, IMBGS. An international team of astronomers witnessed the birth of the first intermediate mass black hole ever detected. On May 21, 2019, a pair of gravitational wave observatories, the Laser Interferometry Gravitational Wave Observatory, LIGO, in the United States, and Virgo, a 3-kilometer-long detector in Italy, detected an unusual signal dubbed GW190521. This signal, resembling 4 short wiggles, lasted less than a tenth of a second, yet it revealed the formation of the first intermediate mass black hole ever discovered. While most of the energy released during gravitational collapse is emitted very quickly, an outside observer does not actually see the end of this process. Even though the collapse takes a finite amount of time from the reference frame of infalling matter, a distant observer would see the infalling matter slow and halt just above the event horizon, due to gravitational time dilation. Light from the collapsing material takes longer and longer to reach the observer, with the light emitted just before the event horizon forms delayed an infinite amount of time. Thus, the external observer never sees the formation of the event horizon. Instead, the collapsing materials seem to become dimmer and increasingly redshifted, eventually fading away. In theory, black holes less massive than stellar mass black holes may also exist. These are called primordial black holes, or mini black holes. They are the smallest black holes. It is believed that they may have been created soon after the Big Bang, where the enormous pressures and temperatures required for the formation of such a small black hole were present. However, these mini black holes are yet to be observed. Gravitational collapse requires great density. In the current epoch of the universe, these high densities are found only in stars. But in the early universe, shortly after the Big Bang, densities were much greater, possibly allowing for the creation of black holes. High density alone is not enough to allow black hole formation, since a uniform mass distribution will not allow the mass to bunch up. In order for primordial black holes to have formed in such a dense medium, there must have been initial density perturbations that could then grow under their own gravity. Different models for the early universe vary widely in their predictions of the scale of these fluctuations. Various models predict the creation of primordial black holes ranging in size from a Planck mass to hundreds of thousands of solar masses. Despite the early universe being extremely dense, far denser than is usually required to form a black hole, it did not recollapse into a black hole during the Big Bang. Models for gravitational collapse of objects of relatively constant size, such as stars, do not necessarily apply in the same way to rapidly expanding space, such as the Big Bang. Gravitational collapse is not the only process that could create black holes. In principle, black holes could be formed in high-energy collisions that achieve sufficient density, but scientists are still arguing about that. Now let me ask a question. Will the Sun become a black hole? Before finding out the answer to the question, be sure to like or dislike the video so that we can continue to improve and make these videos better for you, the viewer. Plus, be sure to subscribe to the channel, clicking the bell, so that you don't miss any of our weekly videos. No, it's too small for that. So what will happen to it? In some 6 billion years, it will end up as a white dwarf, a small, dense remnant of a star that glows from leftover heat. The process will start about 5 billion years from now, when the Sun begins to run out of fuel. Like most stars, during the main phase of its lifetime, the Sun creates energy by fusing hydrogen atoms in its core. In about 5 billion years, the Sun will start to run out of hydrogen in its core to fuse, and it will begin to collapse. This will let the Sun start to fuse heavier elements in the core, along with fusing hydrogen in a shell wrapped around the core. When this happens, the Sun's temperature will increase. and the outer layers of the sun's atmosphere will expand so far out into space that they'll engulf Earth. This would make Earth uninhabitable for life as we know it. Through other factors in planetary evolution, might make it uninhabitable before that point. This is the red giant phase, and it will last about a billion years before the sun collapses into a white dwarf. But what are the most massive black holes that we know? Here's a list of them and how they formed. TON-618, which is more accurately classed as a quasar, is an extremely luminous jet of light at the center of a distant galaxy. Hidden within this immensely bright object is believed to be an ultra-massive black hole. This monster contains a colossal 66 billion times more mass than the Sun and has an estimated diameter of 242 billion miles, or 390 billion kilometers, making it more than 40 times the size of Neptune's orbit. Can you imagine that? Holmberg 15A. This newly discovered ultra-massive black hole resides in Holmberg 15A, a supergiant elliptical galaxy located in the center of a group of over 500 galaxies called Abel 85. Holmberg 15A's ultra-massive black hole is estimated to have a mass of 40 billion times that of the Sun. IC 1101. We know that it might be a black hole at the center of IC 1101 galaxy. This supermassive black hole is estimated to have a mass of 40 to 100 billion times the mass of the Sun. With a distance of about 320 million light years, IC 1101 is too far away to detect black holes with stellar masses. The only current possibility to find such a small black hole would be through gravitational waves. So when two black holes, or a black hole and a neutron star merge. Like most things in space, there is still a lot to learn about these mysterious dark objects, and although TON-618 is currently the black hole king of the universe, there may well be another, even larger one waiting to take that top spot. That's all for this video. Do you think we will understand more about these objects? Did you enjoy this video? What's your favorite black hole? Let us know in the comments below. See you next time on the channel.